I hear the rain a coming down, it makes me sad and blue. Was on a rainy night like this that Flo said we were through. I told her how I loved her and I begged her not to go. But another man had changed her mind, so I said goodbye to Flo. Alone within my cell tonight, my heart is filled with fear. The only sound within the room is the falling of each tear. I think about the thing I've done, I know it wasn't right. They'll bury Flo tomorrow, but they're hanging me tonight. They're hanging me tonight. That night he came and took my Flo and headed into town. I knew I had to find this man and try to gun him down. As I walked by a dim cafe and I looked through the door, I saw my Flo with her new love, and I couldn't stand no more. I couldn't stand no more. I took my pistol from my hip and with a trembling hand, I took the life of pretty Flo and that good-for-nothing man. That good-for-nothing man. I think about the thing I've done, I know it wasn't right. They'll bury Flo tomorrow, but they're hanging me tonight. They're hanging me
since I'm without you. Gray, gray, my life is gray. Cold is my heart since you went away. Red, red, my eyes are red, crying for you alone in my bed. Green, green, my jealous heart, I doubted you, and now we're apart. When we met, how the bright sun shone. Then love died, now the rainbow is gone. Black, black the nights I've known, longing for you, so lost and alone. Gone, gone the love we knew. Blue is my world since I without you.
Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina, music would play and Felina would whirl. Blacker than night were the eyes of Felina, wicked and evil while casting a spell. My love was deep for this Mexican maiden, I was in love but in vain I could tell. One night a wild young cowboy came in, wild as the West Texas wind. Dashing and daring, a drink he was sharing with wicked Felina, the girl that I love. So in anger challenged his right for the love of this maiden, down went his hand for the gun that he wore. My challenge was answered in less than a heartbeat, a handsome young stranger lay dead on the floor. Just for a moment I stood there in silence, shocked by the foul evil deed I had done. Many thoughts raced through my mind as I stood there. I had but one chance, and that was to run. Out through the back door of Roses I ran, out where the horses were tied. I caught a good one, it looked like it could run. Up on its back and away I did ride, just as fast as I could, from the West Texas town of El Paso out to the badlands of New Mexico. Back in El Paso, my life would be worthless. Everything's gone in life, nothing is left. It's been so long since I've seen the young maiden. My love is stronger than my fear of death. I saddled up and away I did go, riding alone in the dark. Maybe tomorrow a bullet may find me, tonight nothing's worse than this pain in my heart. And at last here I am on the hill overlooking El Paso, I can see Rose's Cantina below. My love is strong and it pushes me onward, down off the hill to Felina I go. Off to my right I see five mounted cowboys, off to my left right a dozen or more. Shouting and shooting, I can't let them catch me, I have to make it to Rose's back door. Something is dreadfully wrong, for I feel a deep burning pain in my side. Though I am trying to stay in the saddle, I'm getting weary, unable to ride. But my love for the leader is strong, and I rise where I've fallen. Though I am weary, I can't stop to rest. I see the white puff of smoke from the rifle, I feel the bullet go deep in my chest. From out of nowhere, Felina has found me, kissing my cheek as she kneels by my side. Cradled by two loving arms that I'll die for, one little kiss and Felina goes.
Thank you.
about me. It's all over now. Though I may be blue, I'll manage somehow. Love can't be explained, can't be controlled. One day it's warm, next day it's cold. Don't pity me, 'cause I'm feeling blue. Don't be ashamed, it might have been you.
In the southern part of Texas, in the town of San Antonio, is a fortress all in ruins that the weeds have overgrown. You may look in vain for crosses and you'll never see a one, but sometimes between the setting and the rising of the sun, you can hear a ghostly bugle as the men go marching by. You can hear them as they answer to that roll call in the sky. Colonel Travis, Davy Crockett, and 180 more, Captain Dickinson, Jim Bowie, present and accounted for. Back in 1836, Houston said to Travis, "Get some volunteers and go fortify the Alamo." Well, the men came from Texas and from old Tennessee, and they joined up with Travis just to fight for the right to be free. Indian scouts with squirrel guns, men with muzzle loaders, stood together heel and toe to defend the Alamo. "You may ne'er see your loved ones," Travis told them that day. "Those who want to can leave now, those who fight to the death let them stay." In the sand he drew a line with his army saber. Out of 185, not a soldier crossed the line. With his banners a-dancing in the dawn's golden light, Santa Anna came prancing on a horse that was black as the night. Sent an officer to tell Travis to surrender. Travis answered with a shell, and a rousing rebel yell. Santa Anna turned scarlet, played to Quelo, he roared. I will show them no quarter, everyone will be put to the sword. 185, holding back 5,000. 5 days, 6 days, 8 days, 10. Travis held and held again. Then he sent for replacements for his wounded and lame. But the troops that were coming never came, never came, never came. Twice he charged, then blew recall on the fatal third time. Santa Anna breached the wall and he killed them one and all. Now the bugles are silent and there's rust on each sword, and the small band of soldiers lie asleep in the arms of the Lord. In the southern part of Texas, near the town of San Antonio, like a statue on his pintle rides a cowboy all alone. And he sees the cattle grazing where a century before Santa Anna's guns were blazing and the cannons used to roar. And his eyes turn sort of misty and his heart begins to glow, and he takes his hat off slowly to the men of Alamo, to the 13 days of glory at the Siege of Alamo.
A white sport coat and a pink carnation.
That kind of loving, Lord, I love to hear her when she called me sweet daddy. Betty, such a beautiful dream. I hate to think it all over. I've lost my heart, it seems. I've grown so used to you somehow. Well, I'm nobody's sugar daddy now, and I'm lonesome. I got the love thick blue. Well, I'm in love with a beautiful gal. That's what's the matter with me. Well, I'm in love with a beautiful gal, but she don't care about me. Lord, I tried to keep her satisfied, but she just wouldn't stay. So now that she is leaving, this is all I can say. I got a feeling called the blues, oh Lord, since my baby said goodbye. Lord, I don't know what I'll do. All I do is sit and sigh. Oh, Lord, that last long day she said goodbye. Well, Lord, I thought I would cry. She'll do me, she'll do you. She's got that kind of loving. Lord, I love to hear her when she calls me sweet. Daddy, such a beautiful dream. I hate to think it all over. I've lost my heart, it seems. I've grown so used to you somehow. Lord, I'm nobody's sugar daddy now, and I'm lonesome. I got the love thick blue.
Out in New Mexico, many long years ago, there in a shack on the desert, one night in a storm. Amid streaks of lightning and loud desert thunder, to a young Mexican couple, a baby was born. Just as the baby cried, thunder and lightning died. Moon gave its light to the world, and the stars did the same. Mother and father, both proud of the daughter that heaven had sent them. Felina was this baby's name. When she was 17, bothered by crazy dreams, she ran away from the shack and left them to roam. Father and mother both asked one another, what made her run away? What made Felina leave home? Tired of the desert nights, poverty, grief, and strife, she went her way late one night in the moon's golden beam. She didn't know where she'd go, but she'd get there, and she would find happiness if she would follow her dream. After she ran away, she went to Santa Fe, and in the year that she stayed there, she learned about life. In just a little while, she learned that with a smile, she could have a pretty clothes, she could be any man's wife. Rich men romanced her, they dined and they danced her, she understood men and she treated them all just the same. A form that was fine and rare, dark, shining, glossy hair, lovely to look at, Felina was this woman's name. Restless in Santa Fe, she had to get away to any town where the lights had a much brighter glow. One cowboy mentioned the town of El Paso. They never stopped dancing and money like whiskey did flow. She bought a one-way a ticket from Santa Fe, 3 days and nights on a stage with the rest now and then.
mind that she knew she would find that her new life would be more exciting than where she had been. The stage made its last stop up there on the mountaintop to let her see all of the lights at the foot of the hill. Her world was brighter and deep down inside her, an uncontrolled beating, her young heart just wouldn't be still. She got a hotel, a room at the Lily Bell. Quickly she changed to a form-fitting black satin dress. Every man stopped to stare at this form, fine and rare. Even the women remarked of the charm she possessed. Dancing and laughter was what she was after, and Rose's cantina had lights with love in the gleam. That's what she hunted and that's what she wanted. Roses was one place a nice girl would never be seen. It was the same way it was back in Santa Fe. Men would make fools of themselves at the thought of romance. Rosa took heed of the place was in need of this kind of excitement, so she paid Felina to dance. A year passed or maybe more, then through the swinging doors came a young cowboy so tall and so handsomely dressed. This one was new in town, hadn't been seen around. He was so different, he wasn't like all of the rest. Felina danced close to him, then threw a rose to him. Quickly he walked to her table and there he sat down. And in a day or so, wherever folks would go, they'd see this young cowboy showing Felina the town. 6 weeks he went with her, each minute spent with her, but he was insanely jealous of glances she'd give. Inside he was hurting from all of her flirting. That was her nature and that was the way that she lived. She flirted one night, it started a gunfight, and after the smoke cleared away, on the floor lay a man. Felina's young lover had shot down another, and he had to leave there, so out through the back door he ran. The next day at 5 o'clock she heard a rifle shot. Quickly she ran to the door that was facing the pass. She saw her cowboy, her wild riding cowboy, low in the saddle, her cowboy was riding in fast. She ran to meet him, to kiss and to greet him. He saw her and motioned her back with a wave of his hand. Bullets were flying, Felina was crying as she saw him fall from the saddle and into the sand. Felina knelt near him to hold and to hear him when she felt the warm blood that flowed from the wound in his side. He raised to kiss her and she heard him whisper, "Never forget me, Felina, it's over, goodbye." Quickly she grabbed for the six-gun that he wore, and screaming in anger and placing the gun to her breast. "Bury us both deep and maybe we'll find peace." Then pulling the trigger, she fell across the dead cowboy's chest. Out in El Paso, whenever the wind blows, if you listen closely at night, you'll hear in the wind woman is crying, it's not the wind sighing. Old timers tell you Felina is calling for him. You'll hear them talking and you'll hear them walking.
You'll hear them laugh and you'll look, but there's no one around. Don't be alarmed, there is really no harm there. It's only the young cowboy show in Felina, the town. Nobody knew where he came from, they only knew he came in. Slowly he walked to the end of the bar and he ordered up one slug of gin. Well, I could see that he wasn't a large man, I could tell that he wasn't too tall. I judged him to be about 5'3" and his voice was a soft Texas drawl. Said he was needing some wages before he could ride for the West. Said he could do most all kind of work. Said he could ride with the best. There in his blue eyes was sadness that comes from the need of a friend. And though he tried, he still couldn't hide the loneliness there deep within. Said he would work through the winter for 30 a month and his board. I started to say where he might land a job when a fella came in through the door. And I could tell he was looking for trouble for the way that he came stomping in. He told me to leave Shorty there by himself, come down and wait on a man. The eyes of the little man narrowed, the smile disappeared from his face. Gone was the friendliness that I had seen, and a wild look of hate took its place. But the big one continued to mock him, and he told me that I had better go. Find him a couple of glasses of milk, and then maybe Shorty would grow. When the little man spoke, there was stillness. He made sure that everyone heard. Slowly he stepped away from the bar, and I still remember these words. Oh, it's plain that you're looking for trouble. Trouble's what I try to shun. If that's what you want, then that's what you'll get, 'cause cowboy, we're both packing guns. His hand was already positioned, his feet wide apart on the floor. I hadn't noticed, but there on his hip was a short-barreled bat 44. It was plain he was ready and waiting. He leaned a bit forward and said, when you call me Shorty, say, Mister, my friend, maybe you'd rather be dead. In the room was a terrible silence as the big one stepped out on the floor. All drinking stopped and the tick of the clock said death would wait 10 seconds more. He cursed once or twice in a whisper, and he said with a snarl on his lips, nobody's mister to me, little man. And he grabbed for the gun on his hip. But the little man's hand was like lightning, the bat 44 was the same. The 44 spoke and he sent lead and smoke, 17 inches of flame. Oh, the big one had never cleared leather, beaten before he could start. A little round hole had appeared on his shirt, the bullet went clear through his heart. The little man stood there a moment, then holstered the bat 44. It's always this way, so I never stay. Slowly he walked out the door. Nobody knew where he came from. They won't forget he came by. They won't forget how a 44 gun one night made the difference in size. As for me, I'll remember the sadness shown in the eyes of the man. If we meet someday, you can bet I would say that it's me, Mr. Shorty, your friend.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina. Music would play and Felina would whirl. Blacker than night were the eyes of Felina, wicked and evil while casting a spell. My love was deep for this Mexican maiden. I was in love, but in vain I could tell.
One night a wild young cowboy came in, wild as the West Texas wind. Dashing and daring, a drink he was sharing with wicked Felina, the girl that I love. So in anger I challenged his right for the love of this maiden. Down went his hand for the gun that he wore. My challenge was answered in less than a heartbeat. A handsome young stranger lay dead on the floor.
Just for a moment I stood there in silence, shocked by the foul evil deed I had done. Many thoughts raced through my mind as I stood there. I had but one chance, and that was to run.
Out through the back door of Roses I ran, out where the horses were tied. I caught a good one, it looked like it could run. Up on its back and away I did ride, just as fast as I could, from the West Texas town of El Paso out to the badlands of New Mexico.
Back in El Paso, my life would be worthless. Everything's gone in life, nothing is left. It's been so long since I've seen the young maiden. My love is stronger than my fear of death.
I saddle up and away I did go, riding alone in the dark. Nothing's worse than this pain in my heart. And at last here I am on the hill overlooking El Paso. I can see Rose's Cantina below. My love is strong and it pushes me onward. Down off the hill to Felina I go.
Off to my right I see five mounted cowboys. Off to my left, right, a dozen or more. Shouting and shooting, I can't let them catch me. I have to make it to Rose's back door.
Something is dreadfully wrong, for I feel a deep burning pain in my soul. I'm getting weary, unable to ride. But my love for the leader is strong, and I rise where I've fallen. Though I am weary, I can't stop to rest. I see the white puff of smoke from the rifle. I feel the bullet go deep in my chest.
From out of nowhere, the leader has found me, kissing my cheek as she kneels by my side. Cradled by two loving arms that I'll die for,
one little kiss and Felina good.